60th anniversary of Motown.
Barry Gordy's establishment.
He put it down for so many people. Him and his artist. What do we call it? Hitsfield.
Hitsfield.
It's going to be a great anniversary.
It's going to be a great celebration. Hopefully we get listeners. And we're going to send a shout out to all people in Cleveland that are going through this little ordeal all at the same time. We always invite a call for the cause. You understand what I'm saying? So we're going to have a great time. Let's gather. Thank you. I'm so glad to invite me to come along and document.
You know, I had to bring my road dogs with me.
Jam Source Magazine is going down with Nat. And I will see you there.
All right. Hey.
How that did you say, right?
Everybody, it's Simply Tennille here, all the way from Houston, Texas. But right now, I am in Detroit with one of Detroit's finest. Doesn't he look like Detroit, ladies and gentlemen?
Hey.
Tell everybody who I have here with me.
I'm Judge Craig Strong, Wayne County Circuit Court.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you are one of the land makers, the landmark makers here in Detroit. Tell us why it was important for you to attend this event today.
Well, I grew up down the street.
Okay.
And I had the opportunity to see Motown stars when I was growing up. And I learned how to dance and romance off the music of Motown.
He is so colorful. I absolutely love it. He is a representation of what it is to be Detroit. People growing up right around the corner from these phenomenal stars have changed music forever. Tell us something that Motown has done in your life that changed you. You said the dancing.
Okay.
But what motivated you to become?
Let me say this.
Who you are today.
Barry Gordy, a couple of years ago, asked me, who taught you how to dress?
Okay.
And I said, you did. You did, all the Motown folks, because see, I'm known for colors. I don't have a lot of colors on right now.
You look awesome.
But I'm
awesome.
A man that has an orange mink coat.
Okay.
And all also right. wears a purple mink coat.
Oh, I think I
and
like
when
that.
When I talk about Motown, I'm not Judge Craig Strong from Detroit. I'm Judge Craig Strong from Motown.
Well, as you know, Jam Source is a fashion magazine. I'm here representing Jam Source today.
Really?
And so we just had to get you in this bad jacket. You took your hat off, but, you know, he looks phenomenal today,
well,
okay?
Thank you very
You're
much.
Standing out very well.
And we're from Detroit, so we have gators.
Gates up.
Just black ones, though.
Okay. Nice and simple, nice and chic. Okay, tell me one other thing. When we are talking about Motown and you're talking about Barry Gordy, and the award given for them to expand this. Why is it important to expand the Hitsville Museum?
Because there's more to this story than it's on right now.
Okay.
It's a lot more, and Motown is still growing. I mean, Motown is not over. So this gives us the opportunity to highlight more, to encourage more, to have more people to see more.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about more.
Okay.
More Motown.
More Motown, everybody. So tell me one last question. Who is your favorite Motown artist?
Now, that's a difficult thing to say because there's so
there are
many
so
of them.
Many.
I mean, I don't know where to stop.
Okay.
I mean, I started with Smokey Robinson.
Okay.
And then Marvin Gaye.
Okay.
But, I mean, it's endless.
All right.
And what I like is that there's still so many Motown greats that are still around.
Okay.
And they're still performing, so people have an opportunity to see what made Motown great. And also, when we think about Motown, we also have to think about the writers, the musicians, the producers. I mean, they changed the industry.
The
that's right. It's not just the stars. It's the whole organization. And so many people have been inspired to become like them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we have so many great entertainers and writers now because of Motown.
Inspiration and support staff is the story right here,
right
now. Everybody, there's growth going on right here in Detroit. It's not going to stop. They are setting the standard. This is Jam Source Magazine and Simply.Tennille. Thank you.
My initials are MF.
MF, no, you're going to state your whole name right here for the camera. Tell everybody who I'm here with.
Michael Fuqua.
Oh, Michael Fuqua. Definitely everybody. Detroit has come out to represent the groundbreaking for today, Motown Hitsville Expansion Project. This is also the 60th anniversary. What does that mean to you?
It means a lot. My father's Harvey Fuqua, and as a kid, I basically lived in this building.
Okay.
In this neighborhood. So it means a lot.
Okay. So we are here with yet another legacy. This has become the motion for today. What were some of the things, give me one real good example of something that pushed you into believing in Motown and what it was doing for the community here in Detroit?
Family.
Oh, okay.
My dad, Harvey Fuqua, Gwen Gordy Fuqua. That's what got me motivated, got me involved. And one person you want to hear a lot about is Robert Gordy, Barry Gordy's brother. So that played a role.
Okay.
And there are several people that I can name, Gwen Joyce, Lucy Gordy. So there are quite a few people that played an important role in me being involved with Motown and being appreciated for the things that Motown have done for a lot of people.
So what has made you stick around over the years? You know, a lot of times people get pushed out. People have different adversities that go on. What's one of the things that has made you stick around outside of family?
Money.
So since they're paying you.
Well, it's just like.
Explain that for me.
Well, it's like you have a base. So you got a place, it's home. And I appreciate my home. Even though I live in a place in North Carolina, it's Concord, and in Florida, in Plantasia. So, but this is home base. So I like it here, and so money is a reason, to be honest. And I just like it because it changes the seasons. So you have four seasons here, and you get a chance to have a change of season. And like with the music is always evolving and growing.
Very true.
Like Detroit's home of EDM, Detroit dance music.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot of talent here. So that's one of the reasons why I stay here, because of the talent.
Okay. So everybody, if we can't say anything else about this man, Mr. Fuqua, right here, he is real. He said money motivates him. He said the spirit of Detroit and the music that's here motivates him. And that's why he has stayed connected to Motown all these years. Happy 60th anniversary.
Thank you. That's all I can say is thank you.
Hey, everybody. I am here with some of Detroit's finest, ladies and gentlemen. It's your girl, Simply Tenille, and Jam Source Magazine. I'm going to start with you.
Gary Hunter, Pastor Gary Hunter.
You've done some phenomenal things here in the area. Tell us a little bit about the things that you've done and what you continue to do.
I did more just in here in the area. Excuse my voice. I'm dealing with a little bit of surgery I just had on my vocal cords with cancer. So shout out to October Cancer Awareness. Men, women, everybody get checked. But the last 10 years, I've traveled with President Obama to 46 states, Hawaii, Puerto Rico, and the opening of Cuba. Not only have I captured the moments in the history of President Obama, cities all over this country, including Houston. Shout out to Church Without Walls and Dr. Ralph West, who welcomed me as their Black History speaker, guest, go way back with the Gordy family. They're like families.
Why was this event so important for Detroit today?
It lifts a spirit that we already have to the awareness.
Okay.
People don't know that Detroit are diehards.
Okay.
We like to use the word hustler, we like to use the word go-getter. There's a lot of words people want to use for Detroit, but we have a spirit of don't die, can't give up. If you go and take the tour of Hitsville, you'll see where his father and grandparents came here because of the entrepreneurial spirit that was accepted.
Okay.
Racism has always played a part of taking us to another level because you have to fight to get past that level, which embraces your spirit, embraces your whole kind and being. We have one of the singers here from Love I Am, and God knows that they sing above what they are, and they it's three sisters that are the new Supremes.
Well, since he gave you an introduction, you know, he has compared you guys to the Supremes just there. Did you hear that? Why is Hitsville important to you and the ladies who are singing?
Well, Hitsville is important to me because I feel like this is one thing that keeps Detroit alive today, and also we're setting an example for the future, and I just think that it's important to keep that alive and to spread our legacy on to the new generation, because today music is not the same, and I just feel like we can make a difference.
You need to take it back a little bit, right?
Yes, you know, don't get me wrong, I'm, you know, music today, it has changed a lot. So keeping the legacy alive is very important,
super important
to us. Yes.
So what they do, okay. I can't even just compare them to the Supremes.
Okay.
They'll get a Temptations to run. Because they got this three-part harmony that will put a lot of boy groups to shame.
So you make sure you tell everybody where they can find you on social media. We'll do that first.
Okay, you can find us on Facebook at Love I Am, and you can also find us on Instagram at Love_IAm_.
And
we've got the history, we've got the future.
And brothers, don't think they just fine. They are talented. Yeah, they fine. They candy eyes to the candy eyes with honey and a little bit of drop, but they have a great spirit. They have a lovely spirit, and they can sing.
Okay.
And I ain't saying that because they're friends of mine. I'm saying it because I'm a singer.
You're a singer,
you know,
as well.
Yeah, I've been all singing all my life. Gospel. I'm a preacher. I'm a singer. So when I get through with this throat surgery, either I'm gonna sound like Michael Jackson or Barry White.
We're live from Detroit. This is your girl Simply Tenille at Jam Source Magazine.
Can you tell us what you do?
I have a media company, D Briggs Media. Are we on?
Recording?
Okay.
Go ahead.
There you go.
You're a media lady. You ready?
D Briggs Media is my company.
D Briggs.
And I'm out of New York City.
Okay.
Yes, my name is Donna Briggs.
Donna Briggs.
Yes.
Donna Briggs. I'm Marcus Mudd, A-Tone Productions.
Okay.
Very nice to talk with you.
Nice talking to you.
Today and with Jam Source Magazine.
Okay.
Okay, what's your next project?
My next project, well, I travel all around the world. I do media, I do entertainment. My next project is a movie.
Right.
Is a movie with John Travolta called Throttle.
Right.
So that's my next project.
John Travolta is one of my favorite actors.
Okay.
And I'm also into film.
Okay.
You can see that on atonepro.com.
Okay.
So what would it take in order to work with you and get you to expand your projects into Houston, Texas?
Well, I'm all over the country and all over the world, so I could be anywhere.
Okay. So when are you going to be in Houston?
I don't have any plans for Houston. My plans are L.A. next and back to New York.
Okay. So can Jam Source get some information on you so that we can follow your career, follow the
I am Donna Briggs _ is my social media.
Okay.
Or Donna Briggs on Facebook.
Okay.
Or Snapchat, Donna Briggs.
Okay. And we will be looking for you and John Travolta very soon.
Donna Briggs Talk.
All right. Great. Thank
great,
you very much.
Bye.
Tenille here in the building at the 60th anniversary of Motown. Tell everybody who I have here with me.
I am Dr. Otis Williams, the last founding member of the Temptations.
Of the Temptations, baby. I am living high on the hog right now. I'm super excited to be here with you. What does it mean for an event like this with the groundbreaking and the expansion of the museum?
Well, I'll tell you what it really means to me. To be part of something that would outlive and last us all. When we started out in 1960 with Motown, I never would imagine.
Never would imagine.
No, that I would be part of something that has become so world loved all over the world.
We spoke with your son earlier. How important is it for legacies to kind of carry on the mission? You know, we had daughters here, nieces here, who were trying to carry on Barry and his sister's mission. You know, how important is that to you?
Well, that is very important because music is like a soothing ointment to a troubled soul. And I've witnessed that for the past 60 years. And music is a powerful force. Music can sometimes do things that politicians can't do.
Can't do.
Can go where some politicians can't go. You know, and so I'm glad to be part of something that is that kind of powerful and strong.
Okay, so I've got one more question for you. Performances, everything over the course of the years, what has been the thing that has impacted your life most in regards to music?
Well, you know, with a career that has lasted this long, it's hard to bring out one, but I can bring out one.
Let us have something.
That one would be the last year that President Obama was in power, and the temptation, we were in the Oval Office singing Silent Night with President Barack Obama.
Oh my God!
I never would imagine when we started singing that I would be that kind of high on the horn.
Not only singing for the president, but
our
black
first black
president.
Yes.
Everybody, I am so excited to be here. This has been a wonderful weekend of events. I've got the man right here. I really wish I could tell him to sing something. I'm definitely not going to do that, but it's been a really fun weekend.
Thank you
so much
for being
interviewed.
Thank
you guys for tuning in to Jam Source Magazine.
Today, we will break ground on phase one of our $50 million expansion. Today, the phase we break ground on is called Hitsville Next, and it is, in my opinion, the most transformational part of the development because it is the hub of everything that we will do that is entrepreneurial, that's inspirational. It's where our mentors work with young people like those that you saw here today. That's where all of that magic happens. It even has pop-up businesses for young kids. So we are excited about breaking ground on phase one, and we're excited that you could be here to celebrate it with us. So please give yourselves another round of applause. Equally as excited, this room is full of individuals, corporations, foundations, Motown alumni who have made this day possible. And on today, we have raised over $25 million.
I'm so thrilled to be here with all of you today. I have to tell you, as governor, not everything I get to do is this fun, right? But I am seated between Barry Gordy and Reverend Jesse Jackson, and what a wonderful way to start this week, right? What is happening here at Motown is it is about to grow as well. This $50 million expansion is going to solidify the Motown Museum as an international draw and a world-class travel destination.
What a day. Isn't it exciting? And to think about the fact that we are standing at a spot that is known around the world, right here. And we're going to make sure that they know it even more with the most amazing museum and educational program, entrepreneurial program that the world has ever seen.
Ford Fund and Ford Motor Company, UAW Ford, they were the lead sponsors, lead partners in this project. So they took it from just an idea to something that's reality. So Jim Vella, would you join us, please?
As some of you may know, Barry was actually one of our colleagues at the Ford Motor Company working in Lincoln. And we looked up his reviews, and I'm glad to say he did better. He did better in Motown. Thank goodness. And I think it's really an honor to you today, Mr. Gordy, that when you look around this room, it's reflective of the people who loved your music and what the Motown sound and their operations meant to all of us.
When you think about everything that's happened over the last 5 years under Mayor Mike Duggan and what the work the police department and all city departments have done, This is a great moment in history, a great moment.
The next guy is the angel of this project, Jimmy Settles. I'm going to ask you to stand. Ladies and gentlemen, Barry Gordy.
It was, I owe credit to so many people. It's like, it's wonderful just to be back home, to feel this sorrow and think about everything, you know. Now that most of you all know that I used to work on the Southern Line at Ford, I learned so much from that. I mean, I watched cars going down the assembly line in a bare frame, metal frame coming in the front door and going in a circle around and coming out a brand new car. And I got so many wonderful ideas and thought that maybe I could do that with people, assembly line. That's when most people thought I was a little crazy, because humans, I was told you couldn't do that with human beings. But because all people are made the same way, all people are think the same way. My first few songs that I wrote was figuring out how I felt as a human being, knowing that I, feeling that I was a good person. I felt that all people around the world was like me, and it turned out that they were. And many of the things that I said in my songs, as you heard, including Martin Luther King, they felt that it was getting through to people. And most of that came from my upbringing right here in Detroit. It's where I learned everything and where the people treated me in such a way. And I came across all kinds of people, good people, bad people, and that. And being raised here was the key. But the big key to why we're all here today is my big sister, Esther Edwards. Esther Gordy. Yeah, she is the one responsible for all of us being here today. She had the foresight to follow me around while I was moving to California to make movies. I was throwing out stuff, and she was running behind me. She took all the memorabilia left behind and turned it into this phenomenal monument, the Motown Museum. Awesome. Esther, thank you.
Thank you.
I thank her granddaughter, my grandniece, Robin Terry, whose hard work and dedication has spearheaded the growth of this museum. Along with the museum board staff, they have some of the greatest people, making it world famous and still reaching for higher heights and still growing. And again, thanks to all of you, but not only will this expanded museum entertain and tell the stories of talented and creative people who succeeded against all odds, but will inspire and create opportunity for young people to go after their dreams and continue to make this world better and better. And go after the things that seem impossible, at least for the right reason and the right time. And I'm very happy and grateful that all of you are here. And I had a long talk with the governor the people that I've talked to are just remind me of Detroit and the heartfelt people that we all are. So I appreciate everything, all the love that I've got from all of you. And we'll continue to work, we'll continue to do this thing together. And I love you all.
Strangeland of music. Music is in the key of life. And something that this place means so much to us, hard to express it, this event today. And because Dr. King said to me one day, we couldn't make payroll. Couldn't borrow a black bank in the South. Didn't have enough money. White bank wasn't the money that the guy in Detroit named Barry. He's going to be buried. That card, I went to Ken, came in, see a friend from the South Boulevard. Reason. Ken, me there one cold one today. Sat on his little stool like a little dragon. Big shot, just beside him. And so what's your philosophy? What kind of reason why you were talking about philosophy? Because Motown never sang down to us. We sat down by the group, to love, Jack wasn't big hit. I was blown to this man's body, his mind, came a spirit, an idea. This transformed the world. We're a better nation because of Motown. We organized barriers because of Motown. We built peace because of Motown. We didn't go out to this place, this Bethlehem of music. Done this place here, spawned the hits. And music and the movies. Never stop growing. Barry, we thank you. We thank God for music, we thank God for this, for Gwen, for the mom, the pops, the family. God has used you as an instrument of his peace. We thank you. We knew that God bless you.
It is such a humbling experience to be here, this holy place of music. And in 1 week, Jews all over the world will be blasting the shofar, a ram's horn, which is music. And music is prayer. Prayer is not just word and prose. Prayer is music and singing. And I read from the very last chapter in Psalms. Hallelujah, praise God. Praise God with the sound of the shofar. Praise God with the harp and lyre. Praise God with timbrel and dance. Praise God with string instruments. Praise God with sounding cymbals and the loud clashing cymbals.
God, we ask that you be the builder of this house. And that what is built will not just preserve a rich musical history, but also nurture into the future talents of our young people here in Detroit.
Oh God, the hard work of our dedicated governor, mayor, and other public servants make this small town called Detroit one of the richest, righteous, prosperous, and dynamic top cities in America again.
Hi, Dr. Kim.
I would like to say, voice of the people, I want you to know that I come from the Korea. But Korea, I share about more kind of history. To you, just music, but I know the history. 1619 start slavery. It ended 1865, 246 years. I introduced Mary Gory as a Moses. He opened Red Sea!
It's honorably an honor for me to be alongside her, and we support her, and you know, it's always been my joy to kind of see this kind of come to a fruition for her.
I have an exceptional team, I'm just going to say that, and they went over and beyond to plan this entire weekend. The groundbreaking was just one piece of that, and it just tells you how thoughtful and how passionate all of us are about this. It's not just another building, just another expansion. I mean, this means something, you know, to our culture, to the world. And so everybody, you know, nobody takes that lightly. They are synonymous one with the other. Detroit and Motown, Motown and Detroit. Mary Gordy created that name to show his love for his hometown. So I don't think you can separate them.
Tell everybody who I have here with me and why it was important to be here for this event this night.
Vivian Picard, and I'm on the Legacy Council for the Motown Museum. And I am one of the individuals that's helping to raise money for the to really complete the expansion project. So I'm excited.
I'm Simply Tennille. I'm out of Houston, Texas. I came all the way here just to see this event. Why was it important for you to support this event tonight?
Well, I'm the Vice President of the Board of Trustees of Motown Museum. Had been on the board for over 20 years, very active, very involved with the expansion as well as the planning of this event.
Okay.
And it's my passion to help Motown Museum.
It has been a wonderful event. I just have to tell you that. I've had a great time out here. This is my very first time visiting Detroit. So they say in this book that the Supremes are the very best girl group ever. Do you agree with that?
Undoubtedly. Undoubtedly.
I definitely.
Destiny's Child, Rough Second, Supremes bar none.
Got you. Thank you
Thank you very much.
River wide.